Here we go. We have found him. It's not that as if he's hard to find. It's just whether or not he wants to talk to you. His name is Harry Fraud, and we could be here for days running through just hits that the guy has, and underground just classics at this point. You know what I mean? Harry Fraud, how you doing, sir?
I'm good, my brother. You know, I like to pop out when I got something to talk about. I don't want to talk about nothing. You know what I mean?
Well, you represent Brooklyn, New York. People should definitely look up the Harry Fraud discography available on Apple Music.
Let's take 1 second, talk about Brooklyn. You know my Nets out there. Let's go.
Oh, I like it.
KD, my boy. Purest game you ever saw in your life, man. The purest game you ever. They're cooking right now. Let's go. They ain't even get to practice together yet. Let's go.
Well, look, let's get to this project that just dropped. It's called The Fraud Department. You and Jim Jones have collabed then added some other amazing pieces. People I love in the game, Belly, Dave East, Trav, French Montana, Currency, Conway, Mano, to name a few. How did this Fraud Department come about with you and Jim Jones kind of leading the charge?
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, I've always wanted to work with Jim. Like you said, I'm from New York. You know, if you're from New York in our era, you know what it was, Dipset, Randy City. So, you know, to me, like, that was always something really important to me, but it was never a possibility up until recently because of what was behind it. And obviously where my loyalties and my lineage lies, that goes without saying. So that needed to get figured out first and foremost. And kind of once that got figured out between those two on their grown man business, you know, it just kind of naturally happened. Like French mentioned it to me, like, yo, you know, Jim want to do something. I'm like, oh. And then, you know,
all you got to say is the word, my dude.
I'm just like, you know, Jim hit me and we kind of, and right as we started communicating was when full lockdown went crazy. You know what I mean? In the city. And we was getting on FaceTime and Zooms and I would be playing a beat. And then like slowly but surely, you know, we kind of developed a system for recording, which has now grown into his quarantine studios platform that, you know, he's doing recording and hosting and any music service you could possibly want. And that kind of developed out of us, you know, getting on Zoom. All right, cool. I can remote control your computer. And now how can I find the really trickiest part was finding something that would send the audio back and forth at high fidelity with the littlest latency, which basically means high quality, no delay.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Once we figured that out, man, Jim is quite the engineer in his own right. So he have no problem getting, you know, he told me he was recording a lot of them Dipset records himself and like that. So he had no problem getting in there and figuring it out. And then my engineer, John Sparks, and us three kind of came together as like this team and just started every night getting on there. I'd play beats. He'd love a beat, load that up. Same like if we were in the studio. It was weird. You know, at first it was like, what the f*** is going on? And it just started to develop into like a song, then a couple songs, then a project.
Did you do 88 Coups?
Of course.
Yo. That might be one of like my top 20 favorite beats in hip hop.
And it's a funny story behind that beat. I told it one time, but I was actually in the studio with Joey Badass working on a different song. And, you know, him and his boys, that we kind of like working on the song. And I think he had started writing it and stuff. And he was just like, yo, I got to go take a bike ride or something. Like, I got to like inspire myself. And I'm like, dope, I'll just sit and make a beat. You know what I mean? So he takes like a bike ride for like an hour. I make 88 Coups. Then he comes back and records a record by me and Alchemist called Aim High, Joey Badass Aim High, produced by me and Alchemist. And then he leave and I finish 88 Coups beat, send that to French, and then he go and get Jadig. I was like, damn, that night I just went crazy. I don't even know.
Crazy.
You know, like whatever I was on that night, I need it again, you know?
I want to get to this Conway joint because Jim Jones and Conway, I mean, with a joint called The People.
That was a record that Jim actually wrote right after the incident with Mr. Floyd happened. And, you know, he was really, we were literally on the Zoom that night and it's coming on CNN, you know what I mean? And the protests are starting and everything is kind of like jumping off as we're on Zoom and we're watching it. I got it on at my house and he's like, bro, we got to talk about this right now. I'm like, word, I got something. You know, and like I had just made a beat earlier that day. That's a woman going, people, the people and all that. And I'm just like, it's just fucking me up. You know what I mean? And we pulled it up right there and he wrote it like literally with the shit on CNN behind him, you know, and then we sent it to Conway and Conway, you'll hear. He talked that, you know, and I think it's important, you know, for guys like Jim that. They got a lot of people's ears and a lot of people that like not just fake social media. He got a lot of real people's ears. You know what I mean? Yeah, especially in New York, a lot of real people that's outside. And I think it's important that he touch on it like that. You know what I mean? And touch on all sides of what's really going on. You know what I mean? Because people know who he is and respect his gangster, but it's also dope. Because he's really, you know, he's a deep dude like that, you know? So I thought it was, that this record's special.
I want to know, how did you guys select the features? Because there's not a feature on every record. How did you guys go about that?
I mean, all this, honestly, these days more than ever, man, I'm only about organic working relationships. Like, I'm really now more than ever. I'm never reaching, I only want things that are going to happen naturally and people that want to be involved in what we're doing. You know what I mean? So on all projects, on all levels, on anything that I'm working on creatively, you know, so with this, literally everything is natural. Dave was Trav, we did over Zoom. Dave was at Jim's house one day. They knocked that out. Mino was at the house one day. They knocked that out. Conway, I told you, we had cooked the record, then we sent it to him. He sent it back in one day. He was on it. Worthy and Spitta, you know, those are guys I did full albums with last year. And Jim was obviously on Spitta's album. He showed out on Ride Around in the Coupe. And that was like people's, you know, one of their favorite verses. And so we obviously had to turn around and do that. And it's funny because Jim called me like, damn, Spitta went crazy. And I was like, yeah, because you went crazy. You know, like, that's how it is. You know, he got to show out for you. So everything organic, man. Same old projects I'm working on right now, man. I'm only about that energy, man. You know, I'm not chasing people. That's not my vibe, you know?